Now, after 37 years, last Friday was the very final day of production for the Aussie soap Neighbours. Studio 10 was live from the set to celebrate the end of an era.
Neighbours, everybody needs good neighbours with a little understanding. You can find them over there.
Oh, it's very hot.
Neighbours should be there for one another.
Such a nice day. All of our favourites returned, Dr. Carl, Toadie, Paul Robinson, Harold, as well as many other fabulous cast and crew. They took us behind the scenes, shared their fond memories, what they'll miss, and what Neighbours has meant to them and the Australian people.
On Friday, the cast took this photo after they officially wrapped the show. And what were some of your highlights from the Neighbours show on Friday, Tristan?
I just really loved it, to be honest, which it's... Even though I work in TV, it's mad, like when you go into a studio like that, how different everything looks. And you're blown by like the size of things. I snuck in and took pictures with the Kennedy, the painting that was on the wall, and Mrs. Mangle, because they're the ones I remember as a kid.
Yeah, the painting of the three Kennedy kids. The photo we just saw, there you are with
there we
that
go.
Painting.
It's like a Kennedy kid.
You
yeah.
are look like a missing Kennedy kid, actually.
Yeah, a little Billy there.
There we go.
It was a really emotional day.
It was, wasn't it? I felt really privileged that they invited us on. That was my catch-up with Guy Pearce, who, of course, brought Mike Young back, which is terrific. I just felt really special that they were happy to have us there on such an emotional day and to share all of that with them, which was, I think, really, really precious.
It was beautiful to see a lot of people... coming back and how they were kind of reacting to it. I mean, you always hear about, like, we're very lucky in the crew that we have, and we always tell you what a great job you do, because you do a great job. And you hear that an awful lot, and it's the exact same as Neighbours.
Yeah.
When you saw all the cast coming back, whether they're present or past cast members, they came around. Everyone knew everyone, and everyone interacted with everyone, and everyone was really treated like it was everybody's last day. And I really wanted to see that, because like I said, 37 years in Neighbours, you can have all your memories grown up for your whole life, and you can have what you think it was, and it can be ruined, very easily ruined, by that one day when you're lucky enough to be around anyone and something happens that you don't expect to happen. But it wasn't. It was such a beautiful day.
So
it
do you
really
want some
was.
Of the behind-the-scenes gossip? Yeah, the behind-the-scenes.
Oh, here we go.
Yes. So,
BTS.
The very last line ever spoken was by Jackie Woodburn, who, of course, is Susan
Irish.
Kennedy. And
oh, sorry.
And they then toasted with champagne that was sent by Margot Robbie, who of course got her start on Neighbours but wasn't able to make it back. She sent over a truckload of good bubbles for them to toast. They then had a wrap party, but then a lot of them had to front up the next day for Olympia Valance's wedding.
Oh, gosh, Olympia got married. Yeah.
Oh,
so well, at least timing is everything.
And that was in Melbourne.
Yes.
Well, at least...
No, Dalesford, which is a little bit out of Melbourne.
Oh, yeah. How lovely. What a beautiful weekend. That's kind of fitting as well, to go to a wedding and have more of a celebration. How beautiful.
But there were many tears shed, but, you know, they're also...
We're very conscious of that, being around that as well. You know, it's kind of... Like I said, some people will not watch Neighbours, some people have never seen it, but you have to appreciate something that's had such an impact globally.
Yeah.
And for people who've been there for 37 years, like, it's a long, long time, whether you're a fan or not, that is unbelievable, especially in Australian television.
Yeah.
I think it's great, and it was great for us to be part of it, and I'm so happy that 10 had actually done something about it.
Oh, and it was a beautiful tribute, and like, there was no better person to be there than you. To be with all of those
I was there in
people. Well, I know you were there.
Of course, you're dead right.
You know what I mean? Like, you are an absolute legend, and it would they would have felt honoured as well that you were there.
No, not at all. But I did like getting to interview Ian Smith, Harold Bishop, and to get to the bottom through ancestry.com if there is any relation, if Angela Bishop is related to Harold Bishop, and whether in fact I should have had that walk-on role that I dreamt of on my life, which would have made me Charlene's stepsister, you see.
You planned this.
But actually, I'll tell you a little secret, because I'd had to record the interview with Ian the day before, because he was filming scenes the next day. Mm. But he actually walked out of filming his scene just as the interview was on the telly in the office.
Right.
And so I ended up watching the interview back with him. And we were just standing arm in arm watching the interview back and both crying. It was just a, it was a very special moment. Yeah. And because he's a very special actor. Ian
Spook, he most definitely is. It was great to be there. Remember, that was the last day of filming, but it's still, the episodes are still on.
Yeah.
Make sure you check them out on 10 Peach.
Drama. Like I said,
it's a fantastic show. It was the last day of filming, but the episodes are still there on 10 Peach.